yo, it's the Master G Theater with myself, DJ Boom, and we have a very special guest host today, the one, the only...
Bounce Master, the Mighty One, since 1991, DJ Doo-Wop was popping, my man.
What it does.
My man, DJ Boom. I don't call you that, but
it's okay. Call you that on this show, I'm DJ Boom. And we have our music director,
RBI.
The RBI, our producer,
what's up,
Marcus, is in the house.
My brother right
here. What's up?
And a big shout out to the hosts who aren't here. So Master G and CLB, we see y'all on the road doing your thing. But today, we have a special guest. You will be interviewing the one and only Corrupt.
West Coast in the building.
What do you know about Corrupt? And what do you think of Corrupt?
What I think of Corrupt? I put him in the category with guys like, and let me finish, Keith Murray, right? Like a wild boy. We call those like wild boys. They're a wild boy. He'll smack the ish out of somebody quick. But the bars is top tier all the time, every trip.
What do you think about the fact that he is a West Coast rapper who's from Philadelphia?
I mean, you hear it. You kind of hear it. You know what I mean? You definitely hear it. But there's cats out there that we, like, as far as me, I speak for myself, like Razzcast. Like, you'd be like, that, you know, I know he has that twang, if that's the right word to use, but he still has. I mean, he says it all the time. I mean, people think he's from the East Coast. I'm one of my favorites in the game, so underrated, Planet Asia. That's another one.
Yeah.
He's like one of those god-body rappers from Brooklyn from back in the days, but he's from the West Coast. That's how I kind of see. I mean, even though Corrupt is originally from the East, but I mean, you know.
No, he's not the only West Coast MC who's got an East Coast sound. But speaking of, you know, East Coast sounds, I consider you to be one of the greatest, if not the greatest, MC DJs of all time.
Thank you.
Do you recall the first time that you were like DJing? Because you started with DJing, right?
Yes, yes.
So do you recall the first time that you were like, you know what? I want to give it a chance on the mic.
It was more of a, you know, to separate myself from everybody else that was trying to make a name for themselves as I was at that time, which was, we talking about 89, 90. You know, there wasn't that many tapes out in the street and on the market yet, but there was enough for me to take a step back and look and say, okay, I got to be a little different. You know, I got to sound a little different. So I just took a crack at it. I will never remember what that rhyme is, so don't even ask me. Damn. I don't have that tape.
Do you recall, like, the very first
tape? I remember
tape?
The beat I rhymed to, though.
Okay.
The beat I rhymed to was, it was Chub Rock. Was it Just the Two of Us?
Treat Him Right?
No, just the slow beat, Just the Two of Us. It's
okay.
Called. Bam, damn. Yeah, it's like a slow joke. It's like a B-side or.
But this was on one of your mixtapes.
It was right on the intro of the mixtape, and then, you know, as you know, as time went on, of course I try to master my craft and you know, writing more and stuff. But definitely, I just trying to separate myself from everybody else.
I have to ask you about this because I feel like people don't talk about it enough. You know, as an MC, you were just recently featured on. You know, in a very highly critically acclaimed album, which is Kool G Rap's latest album. Please check out the track Born and Raised, which features DJ Doo-Wop and Grandmaster Caz and a little bit of Marley Marl. Please tell me your two favorite MC tracks you have ever created or been a part of.
But first, I need to shout out Grandmaster Caz because that's probably the first DJ MC.
Hey, that's a fact. That's many people consider him to be.
Right. Two.
So
what?
Your two favorite songs that you rapped on, that you were a part of, either your own or someone else's.
RBI was playing one of them during soundcheck a few minutes ago, which was the first song I ever officially put out in 93. It was called The Bounce Master. It was actually the B-side But when we put it out in the street, it got, you know, Hit Him in the Head was the A side, Bounce Master was the B side. It got more traction, and people were feeling that one in the clubs and on the mixtapes. So it was me rhyming over that old sample. I can't recall the name of it right now, but the Gravediggers used it like 2 years later. It basically was just breaking down who I was. It was two verses, Grand Poobah sampled hook, that joint. And the second one would be Diaz Brothers in, I think, 2000, Return of the Diaz Brothers, where me and Tony Touch went back and forth and you know, did a little bit of sparring. We went back and forth on that. Yeah, on some Prodigy-ish, Chain Drop to My, yeah, that one. That got to be my second one. Yeah.
You and Tony define a lot of people's entire lives of the 90s. You were the soundtrack to many people's lives. But what I would like to do is let RBI be our soundtrack for the next little bit. He's going to spin us into a mix. And when we come back, we're going to do a segment that we call You Must Learn. We're not doing it now. Not doing it now. When we come back. Okay, but right now, the one and only, the R, the B, the I. Take it away.
How I take it to the head, cause I'm fed, aight? Summer Jam was the knock knock, hip a copycat, look out, I'm on some raw rush. Hey yo, sip on the 40s and hit the blunts of life. But what's how I take it to the head, cause I'm fed, aight? Summer Jam was the knock knock, hip a copycat, look out, I'm on some raw rush. How I take it to the head, cause I'm fed, aight? Summer Jam was the knock knock, hip a copycats, look out, I'm on some raw rush. I'm only gonna tell y'all pick up once, I can't hold it back. It's been 3 months, the whole damn summer, I use my slogan, yeah. I was saying bounce while your diggins was voguing. Some try to copy but you just can't sketch it. Saying bounce while your diggins was voguing. I was saying bounce while your diggins was voguing. I was saying bounce while your diggins was voguing. Some try to copy but you just can't sketch it. Then you do that whack and it stretch this. Creativity is what they lack. I've been the bounce master from way, way back. And use a new fool from the new school. Take it personal like that joint from the guru. Yeah, cause Duwop is the champ. Blowing up, while you're blowing out your amp. And yeah, that you're bigger than the wops. Use your own dish. All this water have to drop ya. And get that gat in your mouth like a straw. Tell me, who's the bounce master, man? When they get the London iced tea, then we shut them down cause they got shiesty. 1199, WAP left them all. 2100, WAP had it start. 365, left the pickings in a day. Now you see me at the Fever with Biz on stage. Head and never swell, always say hello. All summer long, rock the old school shell toe. Now it's kinda nippy, so I get the chuckers. Roll with the bounce squad, mama, express. Let's get this and go for a ride. Strap with the gat, so take off the overdrive. We gotta chill and be cool like Fonzie. Play a mixtape by my main man, Ron G. Up with the crew on 8th and we out. Get the same eyes and mix it with the stout. Now the squad is hype, looking for a fight. So if you say bounce, start your grill light. Then go out to all them crumb snatchin' niggas trying to use my flavor. You know what I'm saying? Follow me now. Bounce, come on, bounce. Everybody bounce, come on, bounce. Uptown bounce, Brooklyn bounce. Boogie down bounce, Queens bounce. Come on and just do that shit and just bounce. Yeah, do that shit and just bounce. You know the pop is in the hat.
IBI in DC. What's up?
And we are back. Master G's Theater, but I am not Master G. I'm DJ Boom with the Bounce Master.
DJ Doo-Wop, RBI, thank you for that, brother.
RBI.
Say RBI.
Our producer Marcus, and shout out the one and only Master G who's on the road, and CLB who couldn't be with us today. But every single show, we do a segment that educates. You know, we try to remind people and keep legacies alive. And that's why this segment is called
You Must Learn.
You Must Learn. You must learn. Let me tell you something real quickly before we get into You Must Learn. I want to tell people that they must learn about DJ Doo-Wop sneakers. Can you just hold your foot up just a little bit? Look at this. These are the new mixtape Pumas by Alexander John. The laces. Look at that. The lace. Yoink. The lace is actually like an auxiliary cable.
Auxiliary cool. Yeah.
That's wild, man.
Big shout to Emery.
That's right.
Vegas
shout out
Jones.
These are beautiful sneakers. And
Well, you know what? He gave me the family and friends, but these, my wife was able to cop these for me.
Yeah.
Shout to Toy.
You're very lucky to brag about that. Yeah, okay. Family Woo! And friends, lucky you. Listen, do you remember a song called Adventures of Super Rhymes?
Absolutely, absolutely. Early. What we talk about? Early 80s?
Yeah.
Early 80s. When I used to, you know, I used to go to record store Fordham Row. Fordham Row was like the go-to shopping area of where I lived at in the Bronx. And I definitely got, it was a black label. Might be white or yellow letters, white letters. And I used to play that constantly. It was a long joint,
too. I was just going
to
say, it was a very long record.
It wasn't like a 2.5-minute song either,
no.
But...
it was like super long.
Yep.
But like, you can't be a hip hop DJ in the 80s and 90s and not have that in your crate.
Absolutely. That's
right.
That
so
should
what
be in the beginning, like in the beginning of your crate.
Yeah, and not to mention it rocks parties. Like Adventures of Super Rhymes, everybody loves that song. But today we want to just honor him and say, you know, rest in peace, because we lost Jimmy Spicer 4 years ago today. Okay? And in addition to being what most people consider to be the very first storytelling rapper, okay, he had a 15-minute long debut single, okay, that we were just talking about, Adventures of Super Rhymes.
Super Rhymes, yep.
But he's also been sampled. His songs have been sampled like a million times. Dollar Bills, y'all. Okay, pretty sure that was sampled by
Mano.
Jay-Z is
Jay-Z, Mano. Well, Jay-Z, which
I don't
one
remember
was that?
Jay-Z.
Oh, Mano, right? High
yeah,
Haters.
Mano, yep. Wu-Tang, if you think about the Cream hook, dollar bill, y'all.
Right.
You know what I mean? So that definitely was
he coined the phrase.
I think Busta too. I think Busta used it in something.
Yeah, he used it for Fergie.
Fergie.
Fergie. What song was that? I just played it a few weeks ago. It's one of her big hit records, but she sampled it too.
And also the Bubble Bunch. The Bubble Bunch
is what Busta used for the Busta Bus.
Ah, that's what it is.
The Busta Bus.
The Bubble Bunch, right? Okay. And a lot of people don't know this because he's a house head, but Jelly Bean Benitez's very first remix ever was actually of the Bubble Bunch. So that's his connection there. But, you know, rest in peace to Jimmy Spicer. We're going to keep your name and your legacy alive. Okay, but right now, we have somebody with us.
Who's in the building?
We have someone special on the line. He's not just on the line. We're going to see him appear on the screen. The one, the only, Corrupt, are you with us, my friend?
Looking like $1 million.
The Bubble Bunch.
Mr. Corrupt,
the Bubble Bunch.
Do you remember the Bubble Bunch?
Are you serious?
Right.
The Bubble Bunch.
Yo, Corrupt, you were in Philly? You were in Philly when that came out?
Or were Hell yeah, I was. I was just a baby.
So I'm just jumping into it, but.
No, go.
So, Rant, like, how long were you in Philly before y'all moved out west?
Well, I'm a 72 baby. You
right.
Know, I'm
right.
older than hip hop, cause I'm.
Me
I'll
too.
Be 51 this year, so if this is the 50th anniversary of hip hop, I'm a year older.
Right, right.
So I'm 72. I moved to California when I was 16.
Right.
So I experienced
all of that.
All the wham.
All of that. That's
we'll go right. more into it. Like, what was going on in your neighborhood in Philly that made you even want to get into hip hop? Who was influencing you?
Oh, back then it was my cousin Skippy G, him and Graham B. They had a group. They was rapping. They was battling on the street corners of Germantown. That was my inspiration. I was eight years old. That was my inspiration. And then, you know, it was wax back then. So only one of them, I think only one of us had a actual record player, which was my cousin Trisha. And the record was Mike Struck. Through rain, through shine, even a blizzard. Everybody know that I'm the Ron Wizard. I'm the MIC. S-O. I go by the name of the MC Mike Show. Hey, you know, Mike Struck was cracking, but before all of that, it was Sugar Hill. Curtis Blow was first. Curtis Blow was first, but These Are the Breaks.
A lot of people don't realize that These Are the Breaks had on the flip side not just an instrumental, but it actually said a rap it yourself version.
I don't know nothing about you. Are so above my normal.
How about the Crash Crew? I was telling them the other day because I was with Jazzy J Theodore at the SOBs,
uh-huh.
and they had the We Don't Want to Be Left Behind. Oh, the Crash
Crew.
The B side was nothing. You couldn't play the B side.
Right.
So the A side was like an 8-minute song, and the B side was nothing. You couldn't. Flat. The needle would just fly right through it if you tried to even put it on.
The thing about back then, man, they records was 8 minutes, man.
All right.
7 minutes, man. They had it just banged out and played. The rap come back in, man. They was just rhyming, man.
Speaking
like
of
a party.
And Schoolie D was at this show the other day, too. Did y'all?
Oh, man.
Back in the day, you saw him in Philly? Like, would y'all see Schoolie D and Steady being him in the street? Like,
hey, look, you know what? Schoolie D, Ice-T told me that was the first gangster rapper he ever heard in his life.
He was
the first gangster rapper, Ice-T. My uncle Ice-T said, the first gangster rapper I ever heard in my life, Schoolie D.
PSK. That's most people consider him to, you know, and that beat is so iconic. When
now,
you listen to the drums.
He said that's where he got his first hit from. I don't know if it's his first hit, but he said, this is where I got my style from for one record.
Hey, that makes
Six
sense.
Six in the morning, police at my door, fresh Adidas scooting across the hardwood.
Absolutely.
Yep.
PSK, we making that green. People want to see what I'm saying? Ice-T told me, cuz, I got six. I created Six in the Morning off the Schoolie D flow for PSK. Yeah. Now, a lot of people don't give it up for people.
Oh, yeah.
Right.
Look, gave it up.
We can add Eazy-E too.
Philly.
We can add Eazy-E to that too. Eazy-E's Boys in the Hood is the same flow, same pattern.
Yep.
Did he give it up for Did
probably
he give it up?
Get,
I think they did.
Chance.
I think they did. Yeah.
Really?
I think most of them give it up to Schoolie D for that.
I mean, Schoolie D
so.
Is.
I think so too. You know what I'm saying? Because Eric was like that. Eric was
right.
Solid. He was solid as a rock. But I know Ice-T said to me personally, man, you know, man, I'm in Six in the Morning off of PSK, and that's the first gangster rapper I ever heard. Me personally, when I look at gangster rap, I was in Philly. So, the first gangster. Or I didn't even know PSK was considered gangster. Because then you had Just Ice. Just Ice was just G'd up to me. I mean, Just Ice was a beast.
Yeah.
But, you know, Uncle Ice-T told me, man, your boy is the one. PSK was the one. I said, damn, Schoolie
yeah.
D.
That's right.
Last Friday, he came in the club looking like he's still a gangster, too. And he was with, he walks
shit.
In the club with the actor Dean Winters, Mayhem from the insurance commercials, and the guy from Oz. He was O'Reilly in Oz. He walks in with him. Yeah, I mean, it's like, you know, he's still in the mix. That just kind of showed you he's still in the mix.
Let me update y'all.
Hey, look. Schooly D alone, man. Just let that man be.
Well, he's ain't nobody clowning on Schooly D.
Man, leave that nigga alone.
He came in there looking like a gangster, man, for real.
He about that business, man.
It looked like it, too. It looked like it, too.
I'm telling you, man. Hey, some things you just leave alone.
Correct.
I'm listening to y'all show earlier, though, man. Y'all was banging some hip-hop. It's like, damn, man, you said you was Uba and shit like that, man?
Yeah.
Christ. Oh, my God, man. Grand Poobah? Come on.
Absolutely.
Corrupt, let me ask you a question, because you were talking about Schooly D, and Schooly D is now doing a lot of painting. So whether you know it or not, he's not moved on, but he has expanded his creativity, and it is now quite a well-heralded painter. Do you have any hobbies?
Yeah, Fight Night. Xbox.
Nice.
I'm Mike Tyson. I'm Gotti Mike Tyson. I'm the Iron One.
Gotti Mike Tyson. Are you good?
100
or do you just like playing? Are you good at
100
it?
$100 a game, man. I'm mopping people to death. Mopping them so bad I can't even get matches.
Oh, my.
Right.
You play Xbox?
That's what I do.
No, but I...
You know who else got great paintings, though? My brother Andre 3000, man. He makes great paintings, too.
Really?
He does paintings. You know what I'm saying? Andre, he told me, man, like, you know, he's not interested in a lot of garbage or stuff that's going on, but he's into his paintings. And I'm like, damn, your paintings could go for like $500,000 a painting. He's like, he ain't really into the money and none of that. It's like therapy for him. He loves it. Wow. And that inspired me. And I'm like, damn, you know what? I do need to find me a separate hobby besides Xbox.
Well,
you know what I'm saying?
Well, you're very good at this thing called music. And you have a new single that with Sugar Free. Can you tell us a little bit about working with a guy like Sugar Free? Because Sugar Free, like E-40, they have styles that are all their own. Tell us about...
He's spitting on that, too.
Yeah, tell us about Sugar Free.
I mean, you know, Sugar Free know how to bring fun to the table, you know, because I'll be honest, man, a lot of this became boring. You know, you do so much in the game and all that because hip hop is a hobby. You know, I'm a lawyer by trade. I'm a psychologist by nature. So hip hop is my hobby. I remember my father telling me that there's a million of you. How are you going to be different than everybody else? That made me upset, but also inspired me. And Rakim was my idol, who I really looked up to for his lyrics was incredible to me. His style, the way he dressed, his mannerism, the way that he held himself, and the way he was on the mic. And my cousin Skippy G was also a person I looked up to on the mic. So when I added them all to the table, I really didn't write raps. I just served people freestyle. Freestyle was my shit. You know, I just started clapping them. And I came from that world in Philly. And it wasn't easy because I was only, 12 years old? I was serving 20-year-olds, 25-year-olds. I was serving the elders, 18-year-olds. I'm only 12 years old, man. Killing them with this freestyle. Hello. Just freestyle. I'll spell their shirts. You got a Pepsi shirt on. The P is for this, the E is for that. I spell the shirt. You know what I'm saying? Each letter meant something. They'd be like, ew. They called me the kid. They was like, kid. This kid here, man. Hey. And I just serve them, start talking about their shoes and start talking about them. And so, you know, freestyle became my thing and that I enjoyed it. And that paid me more than trying to have a career in anything else. So then I moved to California, 16. So, you know, it was extra specially fun to serve people in California because they wasn't up on this. They wasn't up on this mic. You stand me? I came with this mic.
You was like an alien when you came, when you got out there.
Oh, because I was the alien. Okay? There was no predators. I was the alien. And I just kept coming out the cut. They're like, who is this guy? This guy right here. I connected words they never thought could be connected. And they loved me. They embraced me. And that's how I won. And as you can see, California's whole mind state of rhymes has changed since Corrupt. It's changed. They take it differently. They take the art form differently. They rhymes have changed.
Facts.
Everything has changed since Corrupt. They care.
Got the Raz Kaz is probably, you know what I mean? Like he'll probably tell us the same story about you, how you inspired the guys like Planet Asia, you know, like some of my West Coast favorites that spit for real.
I don't know. I think Planet Asia and Raz already had their own style. They were different like me. You know what I mean?
Right.
Because there were certain ones that were just already different. And then there was others that just gravitated towards.
Got it.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So it's like, I don't know. Raz and Planet Asia had their own lane. And then you got other ones that there was just certain ones that just they was there already. They ain't had nobody to support them.
Oh, okay.
Then Corrupt came, a part of that major game. And it's like, oh, this is what we've been talking about. Nobody wanted to listen. Well, they listening now.
Do you remember who the very first MC that like you worked with or embraced you when you came to the West Coast?
The very first MC that embraced me when I came to the West Coast. Interesting. Really wasn't the MC, it was producers. You know what I'm saying? And Tony Tovin and Battle Cat was really the first producers who embraced me, took me in. You know what I'm saying? Box was an MC that took me in. King Lou, rest in peace, took me in. You know, these are people, I don't know if y'all ever understand, but they was the best at that time. Kind of like, damn, you know what I'm saying? And they embraced me. But if you're looking for a name, the very first one to embrace me in like that was Snoopy. When I met Dog and we battled and all of that, and then we became friends, and then he made it with Dr. Dre and them, he brought me in the house.
I think everybody knows that, you know, Snoop had this amazing, and you had this amazing relationship, but back up a little bit to Battle Cat. Because I feel like, you know, Battle Cat here on the East, people don't realize just how important and how many people Battle Cat has worked with and touched. Talk to us a little bit about, you know, what you think of Battle Cat and some of the artists, you know, that you've worked with as a result of him.
Well, you know, I was just a kid. I was like 17 years old. And my brother, Broomy, Battle Cat lived around the corner from Broomy's mom's. So we would go to mom's on Second Ave and then go around the corner on Arlington in the hood to go see Cat. He's doing his shit at the garage. And he was the biggest thing we had. Himself and Tony Tobin. Tony Tobin was off 59th. That's where I lived at. Tony Tobin opened his house to me, and I met Dougie D. He was in the game, and there was a couple others, but Tony Tobin was in the game too. So Tony Tobin and Battle Cat, they was in the game from the neighborhood, and you know, those were the first two ever gave me an opportunity. Tony let me live with it. You know what I'm saying? Battle Cat produced records on me, just loved me because I was serving everybody. Hello. The first place I served was the Hawthorne Mall. I served the entire mall. I made them all shut it down. When you go in the Hawthorne Mall back then, you understand me, 88? You understand, 87, I should say. 87, 88, you went in the Hawthorne Mall. They say, oh, you rap? You can't see Corrupt. I ain't even a star. But the Hawthorne Mall knew me and said, if you rap, you can't see Corrupt. Okay?
Is that mall still there? Is that mall still there, or is
hell no?
With lettuce, he didn't even leave the lettuce out, so it wouldn't wilt. So it was 100 tacos lettuce.
Hey, look, if 80 is like that, man, and I'm not mad at him, you know,
it can't
be. He does these things. We don't understand it. Okay, that's pretty weird to me, man.
First of all, that's a weird obsession.
That's his form of love, so I'm not mad at that. Shout out to him. That's all love.
Shout out
M80.
I saw M80 when I went to the Hip Hop 50 concert last month. So he's like one of the first people I saw when I got to New York.
He's been busy for the last couple weeks. He got away for the baby for a little bit.
With his hot ass. You understand me? I told him, man, stay away from the controversy and just do your thing.
Hey, what are you working on these days musically? Is there going to be another Dog Pound album? You know,
Dog Food 2.
He's working on Dog Food 2. Me and Dad, we're waiting for Snoop. But we still in the studio cooking up. Dog going to let us know when he's ready. You dig? And we going to, you know, me, Delmar, and Champ. Because I ain't doing shit without the Champ. I ain't doing shit without Snoopy and Delmar. So, you know, we going to get that together. Me, Dad, and Snoop. Knock that down. Dog Food 2, Superfly. We gonna make this classic and loved. You know, and I'm also working on this Corrupt Presents, A Toast to the Coast. That's what me and Sugar Free and Prozac dropped just now. I got a 50th anniversary tribute record that's on there. I'm finna drop that to him as well, close to December. It's just a tribute to hip-hop. Hip-hop is everything. And I don't mean for me, I'm talking about for the world. Country and Western has accepted hip hop. Rock and roll is a formula of hip hop. Commercials, ain't there a commercial without a hip hop beat? I said, man, y'all don't understand about hip hop itself. And I say to the elders from the Bronx, in New York, the Mecca. Man, look what you created. This shit is so gone. Australia, New Zealand, Japan, Asia in general. All the countries, cuz, can't exist without hip-hop. Alternative music has hip-hop drums. Those drums are hip-hop. Those aren't the regular drums. That's hip-hop drums, man. They still sampling Funky Drummer. They still sampling James Brown. You understand me? I heard something the other day was broke down how it went from, Sylvia, who made Pillow Talk.
Sylvia Robinson.
Created Sugar Hill Records.
Yeah.
Which put out the keys to hip hop. This Pillow Talk of Mine. She was talking about oh, my mama. Hello. Man, they made hip hop, the hippie to the hip, hip hopper. You don't stop the rocker to the. Man, Master G said, man, he's the baby of the bunch. But that's okay. I'm still. What? I guess by now you could take a hunch. And I'm the baby of the bunch, but hey, come on, cuz. I still, what? They'll make you wiggle your behind. Stop it. On and on and on and on.
Crap. We're running.
Bop to the big, the bop, bop, the boo, biggie, bop, the bop, let the beat don't stop. Come on. Come on, cuz. That was hip hop, cuz. It was freestyle. It was fun. It was just, you know, releasing how you feel. Corrupt. You know what I'm saying?
Every time we talk to you, it's a real pleasure to talk to you because you know you're honest, And I dare say that nowadays, Wop and I were just talking about it, everybody's doing something with a motive. But you keep it real, and you keep it authentic. And we want to thank you for that.
Well, thank you. And thanks for having me. You know, me and Master G, see, he's an elder. And he's a part of also the schooling of corrupt, because I'm the baby of the bunch. You know what I'm saying? And his style and how he stood out, you know, all of that matters, man. You know what I'm saying? It's time to give the elders their cool hurt, red alert, all of them. You know what I'm saying? They all Jazzy J. All of them, man, they all did something. I was in Philly during that time. Yeah. I ain't know nothing. That's why I say for the elders, don't be mad at people that don't know, because they're not educated. They're not educated. You see what I'm saying? They don't know because they have no education. And it goes to who do they mind? Who is your elder? Because your elder educates you so you can understand the history of things. They don't know no history. That's why I'm not mad at the youngsters that be rapping and the way they rap and all the rest. I love it, because when I go in the clubs, all I hear is hip hop, the new hip hop, and I have the time of my life. And if I'm not mistaken, that's what hip hop is about, rocking the parties, rocking the house parties. It's all about the house parties. I'm from Philly. That shit come on. You know who killed the parties more than anything and talked some positive shit, but they shit rocked like niggas was straight gangster? My Uncle Chuck D and my Uncle Flaze.
That's right.
As soon as you hear, brothers and sisters, and all children, brothers and sisters, I want, bang, bang, yes, the rhythm, the rebel, it's over. It's over. The party just, and nobody's fighting. Everybody dancing, cuz, whopping, doing the whop. That it was cracking. You know, that's hip hop. And that's why I love this show, cuz. Because y'all allow real hip hop cracking. I'll be listening to the music.
Well, actually, before we let you go, our music director, DJ RBI, has a question for you. RBI?
RBizzle, what it is, oh.
What it is, what it is. I was thinking a little earlier. I saw an interview with Warren G talking about you guys, like how you guys work together between the crews. And he said you wrote some stuff for him. What records did you write for Warren G on his platinum selling debut album?
You know, back in the days, we had to sneak and do it. The Suge wouldn't let us do it. So I wrote it and gave Warren all the credit. I ain't write it. You don't see what I see every day as Warren G.
Wow.
I take a look over my shoulder as I get older, getting tired. And one, I told you. But you know, the original one was the Christmas Carol. That's where I got the whole Wham from. But they wouldn't clear it, so we had to change it. Because it originally was, you don't see what I see every day as I take a look over my shoulder as I get older. Right, and then it was, you don't know what I know. I mean, you don't hear what I hear. But it's so, you know, that's how the original went. And they just didn't roll. Def Jam didn't have that power. So they said no. So me and Warren, I changed it for Warren. You don't see what I see.
Crazy. That is mind-blowing. I am
so
literally speechless right now.
Yeah, my mind is thinking differently on how that song goes now. That's fire.
He changed the melody of a Christmas
Warren,
carol.
I sat with Warren and said, tell me everything about you and Snoopy. And y'all experience, you know, tell me the story. And Warren was telling me the story, and I wrote it. And I wrote it for Warren about him, Snoop, Nate Dogg, and back his name was Snoop Roth and all of that. He just put it all in the rhyme. Warren G loved it, boop. And he was like, man, corrupt, I want to, no, there's nothing you give to me, cuz. Because I was at Death Row at the time, so I was balling. I had it. This is for you, Warren. Because Warren was the first producer that was at Death Row. You know what I'm saying? So at Death Row, Warren was the first one that said, come on, and gave me my first record that was really banging too, and produced me on my first record. So, you know, it was like, man, this is for you, Warren. Snoopy was a part of writing this DJ. We all gave our contributions to each other, you know what I'm saying? And that's what we did back then, because we just supported each other. So, you know, it was Warren's turn. He's at Def Jam. Warren G ain't even a rapper, cuz. He's a DJ, cuz. And Warren G was rapping. Everybody loved him. He was a star on Ain't No Fun. And Warren G was a star everywhere, man. So it was like... And then when you think about it, Run is a DJ.
Right.
Right. Yep.
His name is DJ Run.
Run.
Yeah, man. And he serves rap. As soon as he walk out, he just look at you, cuz, and you're done. You're cooked.
He was Curtis Blow's DJ. Run. Yep.
That's right.
Oh, my mama.
Yep.
And he's the son of, who's the son of Curtis Blow?
Yeah, the son of Curtis Blow. Absolutely.
Okay, then. I'm just saying, though, man. Come on.
You're right. You're absolutely right.
I know my history, cuz I've been watching Crush Groove.
Yes, sir.
Hey, look, I do think we all share the same sentiment, man. It's a magical time. The work that y'all put in, the groundwork y'all laid is still being felt today. And it's worth celebrating while we're doing this 50th anniversary celebration on the whole. So you guys' contribution in that window of time really exploded hip-hop to where it could be right now. We want to say thank you for that.
Yeah.
No, thank y'all for having me, and thank y'all for y'all support and actually accepting our music. You know, we West Coast. I'm from Philly, but, you know, I'm West Coast, cuz. And that was the key to the game, because I'm East and West. I'm called a hybrid.
Right.
I'm a hybrid, cuz. I'm both. You hear me? I'm East and West. And... you know, that's why when I made Corruption, I made an East Coast side and a West Coast side to show some love to what created Corrupt, the East and the West Coast. I was born in Philadelphia, West Philly was where I was born. And, you know, that's where I got my skills, my talent, my everything was Philadelphia. And then I came to California and got my mannerism, my manhood, and everything about it that made me a man. Snoopy taught me how to write records, because I was just a beast. And he was like, you know, we got to calm down. And this is how you write records. And then it was DOC. DOC was one of the ones that taught me to styles. You know what I'm saying? Not just rap. You got to have styles with your... Oh, man, it's just so much.
I would just listen to the formula yesterday. That was one of the most amazing... The way the song just comes on. It's not a beat that comes on for... It's just high energy. You know what I mean? So,
rhythm, amazing. Of the rhythm, and knowledge in the... Yeah.
Corrupt, we always love talking to you, man.
I can't lie. Dr. Dre, too, you know, because the artist is only as great as the producer. The producer, I'll be honest with you, I came from the world where the producer just showed you the lane. And once they show you the lane, they help perfect you, because they know the music. Oh, right. So, you know, I had producers to help perfect me as well. Dr. Dre, Daz, Battle Cat, Tony Tovin. These all are the producers that perfected me as well. So it's a whole team that makes a great artist. Because a great artist is different than a great MC.
When
a great MC is different than a great rapper. A rapper is not an MC. And an MC is not a great artist.
Corrupt, thank you so much for being with us. We're out of time, but... until we speak to you next time, do you want to let people know if they want to book you? Where can they go to book you?
Well, I'll tell them right now, get that Don't Ask Me. Go and check that out, man. Me and Sugar Free on my mama. Mandalay Bay, I have me a residency there for the Raider games. So every time they at home, we're going to be at the, where we going to be, babe? At the Eye Candy. Ugh.
Wow.
Yeah, on Saturday. You hear me?
Corrupt has a residency in Vegas, I mean, at the Mandalay Bay. Yeah. Wow.
Yeah. I mean, hello. I like to have fun.
Wow. Right.
And then my YouTube channel, The THA Official Corrupt. My IG, first of all, with my label, Pentagon Entertainment, Pentagon. Okay? Because we here to defend hip-hop, defend this game. And Official _ Corrupt for me personally. Hello! And thank you for allowing me to be here. You understand me? Because this is the 50th whoop-wop of hip-hop.
Corrupt, we love you so much, man. Thank you for being with us. Until next time, peace.
Thanks, Corrupt.
Talk to you soon, brother.
And tell my Uncle Master G I love him, cuz. I love y'all.
We sure will. And now we're going to let our music director, DJ RBI, spin us away. We are all out of time. But for Master G's Theater, I am DJ Boom with our amazing co-host,
DJ Duwop.
Peace and our music director, DJ RBI.
DJ RBI.
RRBBBIII.
Thanks for the invite, brother.
Thanks for being here, WAP. Until next time, peace. We're out of here.
Bust how I take it to the head, cause I'm fed, aight? Summer jam was the knock-knock, hit my copycats, look out, I'm on some rah-rah shit. Ayy, yo, sip on the 40s and get the blunts of light. But bust how I take it to the head, cause I'm fed, aight? Summer jam was the knock-knock, hit my copycats, look out, I'm on some rah-rah shit. How I take it to the head, cause I'm fed, aight? Summer jam was the knock-knock, hit my copycats, look out, I'm on some rah-rah shit. I'm only gonna tell y'all, pick up another once, I can't hold it back, it's been 3 months, the whole damn summer, I use my slogan, yeah. I was saying bounce while your diggins was bogan, some try to copy but you just can't sketch it, bam. Saying bounce while your diggins was bogan, I was saying bounce while your diggins was bogan, I was saying bounce while your diggins was bogan, some try to copy but you just can't sketch it, bam. They do that whack pen and stretch dish. Creativity is what they lack. I've been the bounce master from way, way back. And use a new fool from the new school. Take it personal like that joint from the guru. Yeah, cause Duwop is the champ. Blowing up while you're blowing out your amp. And you're the chair that you're bigger than the Wops. Use your own dish. All this water have to drop ya. And get a gat in your mouth like a straw. Help me, who's the bounce master, man? When they get the London Ice Tea, then we shut them down cause they got shiesty. 1199, WAP left them all. 2100, WAP had it start. 365, left the niggas in a day. Now you see me at the Fever with Biz on stage. Head and never swell, always say hello. All summer long, rock the old school shell toe. Now it's kinda nippy, so I get the chuckers. Roll with the bounce squad, mama. Let's get this and go for a ride. Strap with the gat, so take off the overdrive. We gotta chill and be cool like Fonzie. Play a mixtape by my main man, Ron G. Off with the crew on 8th and we out. Get the same eyes and mix it with the stout. Now the squad is hype, looking for a fight. So if you say bounce, start to grill, I then go out to the crumb snatch and trying to use my flavor. You know what I'm saying? Follow me down. Bounce, come on, bounce. Everybody bounce, come on, bounce. Uptown bounce, Brooklyn bounce, boogie down bounce, Queen.
this and just bam.